Richard Canini.
Hi. It wasn't easy for me to come here today, but I think it's important for me to share my own personal story. Earlier this year, I noticed a growth on my neck about the time I found out about these small cells. Turns out that I had a cancer called a malignant schwannoma, or a malignant peripheral nerve sheath tumor. It was removed on April 4th at Stanford, but statistically, the prognosis is not good for me. I'm 36 years old. Two of the largest studies ever completed on cell phone radiation and cell station radiation were conducted and released this year. After 20 years, the National Toxicology Program released their studies, and the strongest finding was that male rats had an elevated risk of developing tumors called malignant schwannomas, the same one that I had. Sex and species-dependent increases were also observed for lymphoma, as well as cancers of the prostate, skin, lung, liver, and brain, but these findings were of weaker comparison compared to the malignant schwannomas. The new findings are incredibly important, says David Carpenter, a public health physician at the State University of New York in Albany, who has long warned about cell phone dangers. I think this is the first clear evidence showing that these sorts of radio frequency fields increase risk of all kinds of cancers. He said, noting that malignant schwannomas have been detected in previous human studies of high cell phone risk. And I have been talking on my cell phone on speaker for 20 years right here. The antenna being very close to where the tumor was. Also in Italy, the second largest study was released in March of this year, and it also showed an increase of malignant schwannomas. A statistically significant increase in the incidence of heart schwannomas was observed in treated male rats. The RI findings, the findings in Italy on far field exposure, the NTP study was on near field exposure like you'd have with your cell phones. The study at Italy was like you'd have from the cell phone stations. Exposure to RFR consistent with and reinforced the results of the NTP study on near field exposure, as both reported an increase in the incidence of tumors of the brain and heart and schwannomas in the heart. These tumors are of the same histotype of those observed in some epidemiological studies on cell phone users. These experimental studies provide sufficient evidence to call for the reevaluation of the carcinogenic activity of this type of radio frequency. So let me be your canary in the coal mine here today, okay? It takes years for these things to show up on the epidemiological records. But as you saw from slide number 24, I think it was, in 2005, people watching the Pope, in 2013. This is a much bigger problem than just here. This is a worldwide problem that we're incurring. So, for what it's worth.
Thank you.